Cryptocurrencies and other decentralized digital assets, such as NFTs, fulfill an ever-evolving range of blockchain-powered cases for converging industries, which include the likes of decentralized finance, both Web2 and Web3, the Internet of Things, and artificial intelligence. If you've ever thought about following in Satoshi and Vitalik's pioneering footsteps and creating your own cryptocurrency to help build the future of money, then be prepared for a fascinating but very challenging journey. So in this guide, we'll take a look at what it takes to create your own cryptocurrencies and the various options available to you. First of all, what to understand before you start. Well, there are many things to grasp before you start the complex process of designing your own crypto. Just like any digital real estate on the web, you're going to need to market the new asset effectively to ensure it gains traction and gets adopted by a community. So let's start with the basics. When creating a cryptocurrency, you have the option to create either a coin or a token. A coin operates on its own blockchain, while a token is built on an existing network. Both rely on a blockchain for security and decentralization. And there are three main ways to create a cryptocurrency yourself. First of all, building your own blockchain, so a coin, modifying an existing blockchain, so a coin, or building on top of an existing blockchain, so a token. To choose the right option for your project, you'll need to weigh up additional factors such as legality, use cases, tokenomics, and startup costs beforehand. And depending on the route that you take, you may require anything from basic to specialized technical and programming knowledge, as well as a hefty commitment of time, money, and other resources. Finally, maintaining, nurturing, and growing your cryptocurrency over time will be the biggest challenge of all. And next up, let's talk about coin versus token. So cryptocurrencies can be split into coins and tokens, and it's crucial to understand the difference. While a coin like Bitcoin or Solana exists on its own blockchain, a token lives on a specific base chain, adhering to a specific format like ERC20, so Ethereum, BEP20, so Binance Smart Chain, SPL, like Solana, and so on. Coins have a specific utility over their whole network, such as for gas or for governance, and are normally used to store, create, or transfer monetary value between all participants. For example, some ETH is required as a gas fee to power any transaction on the network, whether the currencies involved are ETH or an ERC20 token. Tokens, meanwhile, are built on blockchains that already exist and provide a specific utility for their own projects, such as governance or staking. They are not used for gas, which limits their use case and also value. Next up, let's talk about the white paper. So a founder will usually create and publish a crypto white paper before launching a cryptocurrency, and it's basically a detailed technical document that explains what the crypto project is trying to achieve and also how. A white paper is very important for early fundraising and drawing attention from early supporters. It blurs the line between an academic paper and a business plan, relaying both technical and economic specifics, including how the cryptocurrency aims to meet a specific need, solve an existing problem, and also improve our lives. White papers should also provide insight into the crypto's tokenomics and also roadmap. They should be easy to understand and offer technical explanations of the project's competence. What to consider before starting? Well, before creating a cryptocurrency, there are a few important considerations to mull over. While most will be simple enough, others, such as legality, could cause you a massive headache if you don't do your own homework. What is the purpose and use case of my cryptocurrency? Every cryptocurrency should, in theory, have a use case or purpose that serves a unique selling proposition or USP for your crypto. This use case, as outlined in the white paper, will determine the type of blockchain and technology that you will use. So which consensus mechanism should I use and why? Well, the early days of crypto saw the preference for proof of work over proof of stake networks consensus mechanisms. And a consensus mechanism helps to process transactions and secure the network, and its choice will affect the energy consumption, decentralization, and security of the cryptocurrency. While proof-of-work chains like Bitcoin are praised for their great decentralization and security, they are also energy-intensive and expensive to maintain. Ethereum last year became 99.95% more energy efficient when it moved from proof-of-work to proof-of-stake during its merge upgrade. Should I issue a coin or a token? While there are big benefits to creating a token over a coin, it's easier and much cheaper to create a token than to issue a coin, which requires you to establish your own blockchain and then try to secure it. So for example, an ERC20 token can be created in minutes and leverages Ethereum's superior and battle-tested security while also having access to a huge compatible ecosystem and community of existing users. And of course, let's not forget many hugely popular coins such as ADA, BNB, TRX, and LINK started as humble ERC20 tokens before they finally merged their own mainnets once they grew too big. However, if you decide on issuing a token, you'll have to adopt the architecture and rules of the underlying blockchain, and likely also all the transaction fees you generate will be denominated in its native asset. So for example, all ERC20 token transactions require some ETH for gas in order to execute. Now let's talk about the tokenomics. So tokenomics is an absolutely vital component of any cryptocurrency, which is still completely misunderstood by some crypto investors. Tokenomics relate to the supply and demand of your cryptocurrency and is an essential element for any savvy investor who might look at how many coins or tokens will be created, how they are released over time, how much is owned by the creators or early investors, and how they are burned or bought back in order to curb emissions. Get it wrong and your project will eventually pay the price. Do I get a developer or build it myself? Well, designing, building, and maintaining a cryptocurrency is no small feat. Even Satoshi Nakamoto had some help when launching Bitcoin, and also requires specialized technical expertise. If you're not a developer, there are options to create it yourself or hire a blockchain developer or service provider. This can also become very costly depending on the scale of your chain scopes and also activity. Next up, let's talk about the white paper and also website. Is your white paper sophisticated, specific, and different, yet simple enough to understand? Creating a clear and concise white paper and website helps to claim a rightful stake for your cryptocurrency and aligns your vision and strategy with its roadmap for the whole world to see and also invest. Three ways to create a cryptocurrency. Now that you hopefully know what you want to build and why, it's time to actually create your magic internet money. And there are three main ways in which you can create your own crypto asset. And the first one is modifying or forking an existing chain. Then we have building on an existing layer one or layer two blockchain. And then we also have creating a new blockchain. So creating a coin. Launching your own chain to create a cryptocurrency is the most difficult path by some margin, as it requires resources such as advanced coding and other technical skills. While educating yourself through online courses can help, they may require some pre-existing knowledge and also may not be in-depth enough. First of all, let's talk about modifying or forking an existing blockchain, so creating a coin. Don't have the resources to create your own blockchain? Well, you can actually use the source code of another blockchain to create a new blockchain and native digital currency. Forking an existing blockchain actually might be quicker and less complicated than creating a new one from scratch, since the code for most blockchains is open source, allowing you to download and modify it as you wish. And this method still requires advanced technical knowledge to avoid security vulnerabilities, bugs, flaws, and other issues. And then we have using an existing platform, so creating a token. If you don't know how to code and/or don't have a big budget, this is definitely the path to take. In 2023, it's easy to launch a cryptocurrency or token on an existing platform like Ethereum or EVM-compatible chains such as Binance Smart Chain or ETH Layer 2 chains such as Optimism. Ethereum Network uses the ERC-20 standard, which is less technical than the others and also doesn't require as much programming knowledge. However, your cryptocurrency is dependent on the blockchain that you choose. Can't code? No problem. There are plenty of developers and companies that can do the technical work and then hand you a finished product. It's also a good idea to at least learn a bit of programming in order to understand the existing blockchain infrastructure, and of course the platform that you're working on, and then figure out when you're being overcharged for your ignorance. So here is the step-by-step guide on how to create a cryptocurrency. It's really the general process and it's going to be kept simple. We will assume that you're going to create a cryptocurrency with a real purpose and vision. So step one, research the use cases. Before you start building, figure out the following as we covered earlier. What are the use cases and unique selling proposition? What problem does it solve? And also what benefits will it offer to potential users? Is there any chain already doing it? And if so, can you do it better? Creating a new crypto asset is no different from launching a new startup business in many ways, and the same planning is required to garner enough hype, something that the new generation of NFT founders is becoming very adept at. Do a lot of marketing analysis and research in order to boost your chances of achieving a real product and also market fit. Knowing what problem your token solves will also help you identify a responsive target audience and create a highly targeted marketing plan post-launch. Now, step two, choose a consensus mechanism. Choose a mechanism that aligns with your goals and requirements, such as computation-intensive proof-of-work or energy-efficient proof-of-stake. Some mechanisms are very innovative, such as Solana's proof of history or POH, but it also can come with other problems. Now, step three, select a blockchain platform. Choose a blockchain platform to host your token. Ethereum and Binance Smart Chain are popular choices, but there are many other options to consider, and consider factors such as cost, scalability, and security when making your decision. Now, step four is publish your white paper on your website and social media. With steps one and three behind you, you should really understand what you're trying to build inside and out by now. It's time to put this information together in your own manifesto. Research successfully launches by other chains and figure out what they did right and wrong. Compare their post-launch results with their tokenomics and network emissions. Create your own tokenomic structure in response. Now, write your white paper and publish it on your website, then share it far and wide. And step 5 is design the nodes. Nodes are the building blocks of a blockchain that store and verify your transactions. Get the necessary hardware such as processors, memory, and disk size if it's required. And step 5 is establish your blockchain's internal architecture. Now, create your blockchain's internal architecture and its rules and parameters such as address and public-private key formats, permissions, and how the crypto asset will be issued. Be sure to carefully consider these factors as they cannot be changed without a software upgrade once the platform is running. And step 6 is create your coin or token. Now it's finally time to create your crypto asset. If you're going the ERC20 route, then you can take an online course first, and you can also use one of the many free online tools. But be sure to do some thorough research first. Make sure the platform can be trusted and is capable enough in order to avoid malicious code and also scams. Alternatively, hire a blockchain developer with good ratings on a crowdsourcing freelancer site if you can actually afford it. And step 7 is design the API and user interface, or UI. Design a user-friendly interface to help your blockchain communicate with its participants. And step 8 is promote your crypto and build a community. Okay, proud new parent, it's time to spread the word about the newly chosen one to build your devoted followership. Reach out to crypto influencers, but of course, not pump and dump shillers. Find a partner IDO launchpad or exchange to list your asset. Develop a campaign, do airdrops if viable, and participate in relevant online communities and also forums. And if you're in the US, understand what the Howey test is to avoid securities-related legal issues later. So creating your own cryptocurrency may seem like a daunting challenge at first, but so is the prospect of unbanking yourself and managing your own wealth. Follow the information and steps in this guide closely, and you should be well on your way to what will hopefully turn out to be a passionate new lifelong pursuit. And let's of course hope that this pertains to you and not the regulators chasing you. Good luck on your journey, keep learning and building, and do what you must to stay off the dead coins list.